What's up, my friend? Abbie here, and welcome to another episode of Writer's Life Wednesdays. Today, we're talking about backstory and exposition, two words that make a lot of writers cringe. A few days ago, I posted on my blog all about backstory in your novel, how to include backstory in your novel without boring your readers to sleep, and let's just say it was a long post, but a very helpful post, and I will leave the link in the description box below so that you can go check it out and read it. It's kind of like a companion to this video, and this video is kind of a companion to it. Yeah, you should go read it, just saying. But as I was writing this post, I was thinking to myself, I'd really like to do a video about this and delve more into why exactly exposition or revealing backstory is actually a good thing. Let me show you. Or tell you. I love writing backstory. It just makes me happy, okay? So you can imagine how disheartening it is when I hear the popular writing advice of avoid exposition at all costs because nobody wants to read backstory. Oh, okay. For a long time, I heeded this advice. I thought it was right. But I soon discovered it's actually not quite right. First, let's break down the word exposition. It essentially means info dumping or giving the audience all the information that they need to know in order to understand what the heck is going on. Whether that information is a scientific or historical explanation of something, world building, or something about the character's past that helps the reader understand why he acts and thinks the way he does right now. But wait, one of those things is not like the other. Do you know which one it is? Okay, since you're not saying anything, I'll just tell you. It's the character's past. Backstory. Backstory. The character's past, but more specifically, what happened in their past that affects who they are today. Why do we need to know this? Because it is the story. Didn't see that coming, did you? All stories are character driven, at least all the ones that are actually good and hold your attention. Why? Because you are character driven. You can relate to a person with desires, fears, and struggles because you are a person with desires, fears, and struggles. But in the same way, you don't care about a stranger you pass on the street, you don't care about a character that you know nothing about. And if I've learned anything from watching all 6 seasons of Downton Abbey several times, I learned that if you can make people emotionally invested in your characters, you don't even need a good plot. But that's another video for another time. Right now, all I want to talk about is exposition. I can understand why people think exposition is bad because, I mean, let's face it, nobody wants to open a book or start watching a movie and just be buried under a pile of cut and dry information.
Our founders built the wall to keep us safe, and they divided us into 5 groups. The smart ones are an erudite. Amity farm the land. Candor value honesty. And then there's dauntless. My faction is abnegation.
Now, when it comes to world building and understanding the facts behind certain scientific things or historical things, you would be surprised by how much the human brain can piece together and understand without much information at all. But human emotions are a little more complicated. And human emotions are the driving force behind your story. You have to get this right. But how? How do you make someone care about a character that they were just introduced to 3 seconds ago? I don't know, why do you care about your best friend? Because you know what her dreams and desires are. You know what she's afraid of. You know what she gets wrong, the things that she mistakenly believes are true. You know her backstory, therefore you care about her. Why do you care? Because you know how she feels. Maybe not exactly, but you can essentially look at things from her point of view and understand why she feels the way she does. And that's what we want our readers to do with our characters, right? That's why backstory is important. But how do we include backstory in our stories without exposition? We can't. Backstory is essentially exposition, handing the audience information they need to know in order for them to understand why they should care. So here's the real question. Should exposition always be avoided? No. No. Wait. Wait. Let's use an example so you don't throw tomatoes at me. The highly successful Disney film that grossed over $1.2 billion and should under no circumstances be called better than Tangled, Frozen. The first 11 and a half minutes of this film is pure backstory, showing us exactly how Anna and Elsa's relationship began and eventually collapsed, which sets up the conflict for the rest of the entire film. So what do we learn about our protagonist here, Elsa? We see the moment that changed everything. The moment she accidentally hurt her sister, dooming her to a life of isolation. What she really wants, what she believes would really make her happy, is to be free. But she can't be, because she's the queen and has to run the country. But it's not just her responsibility that's standing in her way. It's the deep-seated fear that sprang from the fateful moment in her past. Fear of hurting other people with her power. Specifically, Anna. See what a juicy, irresistible conflict this creates? You probably wouldn't feel the same way about Elsa if the movie opened where the story actually begins. Instead, you would probably be thinking, why is this girl so afraid of letting people come over her house? Is she just an introvert? Lots of successful movies and books use exposition not to dump a whole bunch of information on the audience, but to make them care about what's happening to the characters, essentially grabbing them by the throat and not letting them go. I've said it before, and I'll say it again, and I'll say it forever. Story is not about what happens. It's about how the characters change as a result of their journey. All good stories are character-driven, so don't believe anybody who tells you that it's bad to give the audience more information that they need in order to make the deepest possible connection with your character. But remember, the only things about your character's backstory that truly matter right out of the gate. What the character desires and believes will make them happy. What the character is afraid of, slash their worst case scenario. And what the character mistakenly believes is true about the world and the event in their past that made them think this way. I'd love to talk more about this all day long, but for the sake of your precious time, I will shut up now. But I might make more videos like this in the future about info dumping and world building and how to explain things without boring your readers to sleep. So if you want to see more videos like that, smash that like button so that I know that you like this video and you'd be interested in seeing some more videos kind of like this. And now it's time for you to join the discussion. Comment below and tell me what you thought of this video. Tell me what you think of this whole topic. How do you feel about exposition or info dumping or learning a whole bunch of stuff about a character's backstory when a book first begins, or a movie, any kind of story? What do you feel about it? What are your thoughts on it? Everybody has an opinion on it, right? So comment below and let me know yours. I'd love to chat with you. I reply to every comment and I just so appreciate your feedback. And just, I so appreciate you being here, sitting there watching this video. Also, be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because I post videos every Monday and Wednesday. Wednesday is, of course, Writer's Life Wednesday, and next Wednesday is going to be a really special, fun video. I'm not gonna say anything else about it except that, but yeah, it's gonna be fun. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. I will see you around, my friend. Rock on.